This is 2LO, the London station of the British Broadcasting Company calling. 2LO calling.
Broadcasting is a development with which the future must reckon, and reckon seriously. Here is an instrument of almost incalculable importance in the social and political life of the community, in affairs national and international.
This is London calling. Now tonight our chairman, Lord Gainford, is going to speak to you on this, the occasion of the opening of our new studio at 2 Savoy Hill, London.
As chairman of the British Broadcasting Company and on the occasion of the opening of our new London studio, I am glad to have the opportunity of saying a few words to our many thousands of listeners in throughout the country. The Broadcasting Company is not a monopoly. Last year, the manufacturers of wireless apparatus met together by invitation of the post office, as it was realized that broadcasting would have to be controlled by one broadcasting authority if the chaos which today is so obvious in America were to be avoided here.
On the air, if you have a little time to spare, you'll enjoy each minute, I declare. Why, we're on the air.
Here is Mr. F. Hope Jones, our time expert.
Stand by. Are you ready? The last 5 seconds of the hour and the last one will be the exact hour. Pip, 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 pip.
Good evening, everyone. This is A.J. Allen. I remember one night in 1923, I'd been to Savoy Hill telling some story or other, and afterwards I was sitting in what they call the drawing room, having a yarn with the announcer.
This is London calling. Mr. Pugh informed the Prime Minister that the TUC had decided to terminate the general strike forthwith.
Bye, everyone, and here's to the next time.
Well, the first half has been about as exciting as anyone could wish for. Oh, I can't tell that. They're off again. They're changing over. It's Wales's kick this time. Pearl's taking it. He's kicking to the left. Wales defending the south end now.
Square
there
seven.
There he goes, a long one. Sellers caught it.
My dear friends of the Promenade Concerts, I cannot tell you how glad I am to be with you tonight. The last night of a remarkable season.
As to programs, don't expect too much in the early days. The programmes will neither be very interesting nor very good.
Through one of the marvels of modern science, I am enabled this Christmas Day to speak to all my people throughout the Empire.
Events of major importance happened in Europe today. This morning, German troops made a formal entry into the demilitarized zone on the left bank of the Rhine.
Little Miss Bouncer loves an announcer down at the BBC.
She doesn't know his name, but how she rejoices when she hears that voice of voices.
At the present moment, the whole street is lit up. When I say lit up, I mean lit up by fairy lamps. We've forgotten the whole Royal Review. We've forgotten the Royal Review. The whole thing is lit up by fairy lamps. It's fantastic. It isn't a feat at all. It's just... it's fairyland. The whole feat is in fairyland.
Well, I'd like to be able to bring this bunch of records to you. And then I'd see from the look on your face whether each one pleased you or bored you. Songs, for instance, that we've heard so often, sung by our friends or by professional artists or played by bands or broadcast, do they still come to your mind with the fragrance of memory?
Good afternoon. I suppose one of the most difficult jobs to explain over the wireless is the pruning of fruit trees. I've had a good many tries, but I doubt whether I've ever made much of a success of it. But in response to many requests, I'm going to have another try.
It's Monday night at 7. Can't you hear the chimes? They're telling you to take an easy chair, to settle by the fireside, look at your radio times. Monday night at 7's on the air. Now here's a little lady, she'll imitate for you some personalities you've all adored. So let's ring up the curtain on Monday night at 7 and start the evening.
Bandwagon, come on and make a trip upon the bandwagon. It's a wow, boys, it's a grand wagon. Come on and make a trip and join the bandwagon starting now, boys.
Anyway, Mrs. Bagwash isn't worried about it.
Oh, she doesn't care a hoot. She said to me this morning, it's no good them Germans sitting up in those balloons over London trying to frighten us because they can't.
Travel on the bandwagon, come on and take a trip upon the bandwagon. Starting now, boys, make a trip.
Skiddly boom,
make a rip.
Skiddly boom,
join the bandwagon. Starting now, boys.
This is London. At 9 a.m. this morning, His Majesty's Ambassador in Berlin informed the German government that unless not later than 11 a.m. British summer time, today, September the 3rd, satisfactory assurances to the above effect had been given by the German government and had reached His Majesty's government in London, a state of war would exist between the two countries as from that hour.
About a quarter to 10, Prime Minister's secretary handed me this. And this was a communique giving the terms of this country's ultimatum to Germany, saying that it would expire at 11 o'clock and the Prime Minister would broadcast at 11:15. I then stayed on after doing that and announced Neville Chamberlain from the cabinet room and was the only person with him in the room while he made the terrible speech he had to make.
Now may God bless you all, and may he defend the right. For it is evil things that we shall be fighting against. Brute force, bad faith, injustice, oppression, and persecution. And against them I am certain that the right will prevail.
Here is the Midnight News, and this is Alvar Liddell reading it.
This is the BBC Home and Forces program. Here's the news. This is Wilfred Pickles reading.
Here's the man again, here's the man again, here's the zombie and the idiot.
Proceeding with perpicacity, perpetuating pusillanimous prevarication, persistently producing paradox of hippie, well, forevermore.
Pride and joy, we command the void, joy, good luck to complain. When trouble's ruling, it's misery, and then again.
Can I do you now, sir?
The BBC, Ram Bottom, Van Enoch, and me.
Ladies and gentlemen, workers, playtime!
We'll meet again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again sometime.
But how are you today? How's your tongue? Is it smooth and red, or knobby and beige with an overcoat of a muddy hue?
This is the BBC Home and Forces program. This is Bruce Belfridge. The Axis forces in the Western Desert, after 12 days and nights of ceaseless attacks by our land and air forces, are now in full retreat.
Underneath the lantern, by the barricade, darling, I remember the way.
Walter Elliott, Malcolm Sargent, Julian Huxley, Professor Jared and Commander Campbell are sitting in their corners with that quiet air of confidence only possible in the case of masters of ringcraft. That is the brain trust. The seconds are out of the ring, and here are the questions.
Aye, gang.
Shipmates ashore, men of the Merchant Navy from their well-known club near Piccadilly Circus send out their own program over the seven seas. And here to begin it is their cheerful hostess and yours too, Doris Hare. D-Day has come. Early this morning, the Allies began the assault on the northwestern face of Hitler's European fortress. The first official news came just after 9:30, when Supreme Headquarters of the Allied Expeditionary Force issued communique number one. This said, under the command of General Eisenhower, Allied naval forces supported by strong air forces began landing Allied armies this morning on the northern coast of France.
Leslie Mitchell in London.
Ben Grauer in New York.
And from London and New York, Atlantic Spotlight.
The British, Canadian, and American troops who landed on the coast of France, north of the lovely town of Caen, in broad daylight this morning, are already several miles inland, on a front sufficiently broad to be more than a bridgehead.
I'm lying down at full length here in the cornfield. Just in the hedges around me, I can see many men taking shelter behind the banks wearing their steel helmets while this terrific barrage goes on around us. In this barrage, we've got our 4.2-inch mortars, our field guns, our medium guns, all the guns of the fleet. The shells are whistling overhead now. Just listen to them.
Here, over an acre of ground, lay dead and dying people. You could not see which was which, except perhaps by a convulsive movement or the last quiver of a sigh from a living skeleton too weak to move.
There'll be bluebirds over the white cliffs of Dover tomorrow. Just you wait and see.
The German radio has just announced that Hitler is dead.
Now we're breaking into our programs with some splendid news from Moscow. Berlin has fallen.
This is London. The Prime Minister, the Right Honourable Winston Churchill.
Yesterday morning at 2:41 a.m. at General Eisenhower's headquarters, General Jodl, the representative of the German High Command, and of Grand Admiral Dönitz, the designated head of the German state, signed the act of unconditional surrender of all German land, sea, and air forces in Europe to the Allied Expeditionary Force.
Scientists, British and American, have made the atomic bomb at last. The first one was dropped on a Japanese city this morning.
There will be sporadic rain over the whole country with thunderstorms in places, but there will be bright intervals in most districts. The weather will continue warm except on the northeast coast where there will be local fog. There's also news today of a long-lost friend, the Large Depression. It's turned up again between Ireland and the Azores, where it's reported at the moment to be almost stationary.
Good morning, everyone. This is the BBC Night Programme on wavelengths of 1,500 and 261 metres.
Dick Button, Special Agent.
Who broke Nelson's column over my head?
Hello, Mr. Button. Unfortunately, we haven't time to play games just now.
Some other time, maybe.
I think not, Mr. Barton. You have played your last game.
Oh, blimey. Haven't we heard that remark before, sir?
Only about 200 times. You know, you might as well pack in, Betts. You've had it. We've got you just where we want you.
My dear Mr. Barton, I can't help feeling that the boots are on the other feet. We have got you just where we want you.
We've come round the pips for 9 o'clock. Now let's go round the corner and meet Kenneth Horne for Housewife's Choice.
And round the corner I am. Good morning.
took a great deal of pluck to tackle that maniac.
No, more luck than pluck, sir.
Oh, well, luck, pluck, deduction, or observation, whichever it was. It resulted in the capture of the gang who did that train job. By the way, 49, I've had a word with your inspector, and I fixed it for you to have a further 48 off. I think you've earned it.
Oh, thank you, sir. Thank you very much indeed. Isn't that wonderful,
oh,
Joan?
Oh, marvellous. But we'll keep in close touch, Inspector.
Keep in touch? What for?
Well, you never know. Something important might crop up, and where would you be then?
Why, Joan.
Where would I be?
Yes, without Archie and...
Oh, me. My Sunday helmet.
We present Peter Cook as Paul Temple and Marjorie Westbury as Steve in Paul Temple and the Lawrence Affair, a serial by Francis Durbridge.
Hello, children. Everywhere. This is Uncle Mac. Good morning to you all.
This is the BBC third program. How to listen, including how not to, how you ought to, and how you won't, by Stephen Potter and Joyce Grenfell. How?
Are you sitting comfortably? Then I'll begin.
To begin at the beginning. It is spring, moonless night in the small town, starless and Bible black, the cobble streets silent and the hunched quarters and rabbit's wood limping invisible down to the slow black, crow black fishing boat bobbing sea.
Please, Mr. Grouse, sir, would you like me to carry your bag?
Carry my bag, lamb? Where to? Oh,
Mr. Grouse, sir, if you will give me a penny, I will carry it to the other train. You see, you have to get out of this train and get into another, because this one doesn't go any further.
Then why didn't that numbskull of a porter say so, instead of shouting at me in an offensive manner?
Come where the stars are always bright. Begone, dull care. It's Blackpool night.
It gives me great pleasure.
Yes, yeah, I must say that. It gives me great pleasure as well.
What are you talking about?
What are you talking about?
I was saying it gives me great pleasure to be appearing on the show.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh,
add much finding in the marsh.
Although we've had a rarely good vacation, tiddly-pop-pop.
Add much finding in the marsh.
We are happy to be back in circulation. It seems to us like ages since this little song we sang.
And in the interim, I think the piano's had a prang.
It's all right on the... Then suddenly goes...
And much binding in the marsh.
We present Peter Brock and Archie Andrews in Educating Archie.
Flippin' kids.
We present Tony Hancock, Sidney James, Bill Kerr, Hattie Jakes, and Kenneth Williams in...
Hancock's Half Hour.
German officer outside, sir.
I surrender.
He's a prisoner, sir.
Oh, bring the coward and his money in.
Take it from here. Don't go away when you can take it from here. Why don't you stay and maybe join in the fun? Now the show has begun.
Yes, Dick Bentley and Jimmy Edwards will be on hand for the next 30 minutes. With Wallace Eaton, Alma Cogan, June Whitfield, and the keynotes, all inviting you to...
Take it from here.
You will have seen in your Radio Times the details of the new music program which starts today.
This is the gentle beginning which will gather strength until by next March the BBC will broadcast more than twice as much good music as now.
This is Network 3. It's something new in sound broadcasting. In fact, it's the first time that these words have been heard on the air. They mark the beginning of a new BBC service, quite different from anything we've done or experienced in past years.
The year was 1957, the morning bright and gay. On the 9th of February, John Erickson drove away in a Class 8 locomotive from Buxton he did go. On the road to Chapel Unley Frith, his steam brake pipe did blow.
Jimmy Kingsbury is going to give a few directions for anyone who may be listening to stereophonic broadcasting for the first time.
And to do so, I'm now moving from your right to a central position.
This program is an experiment, an exploration. It's been put together with enormous enthusiasm and equipment designed for other purposes. It's not a masterpiece, not even a minor one, and it's not a stunt. We think it's worth broadcasting as a perfectly serious first attempt to find out whether we can convey a new kind of emotional and intellectual experience by means of what we call radiophonic effects.
Journey into space. The BBC presents Jet Morgan in Operation Luna.
News has just come in that President Kennedy has been shot. There's no news yet of his condition. It happened as the president was riding with his wife in an open car through the streets of Dallas, Texas.
It's 11 o'clock and time for Pick of the Pops, presented by David Jacobs.
Pennies worth at the moment. Millie still waits patiently. Roy Orbison and the Foremost keep up the pressure. Scylla flashes in like a bomb. Cliff's there too. And it's the next Pick of the Pops. Next Sunday. All right? Right. Stay bright.
Hello, me old mateys. I'm very glad you could come this morning. And we're kicking off straight away this week with a double event, a 21st birthday and a wedding.
Cut your hair once a year, boys. Cut your hair once a year. If it covers your ear, you can't hear, boys. So cut your hair once a year. All together now. Tie me kangaroo down. Sport. Tie me kangaroo down. Tie me kangaroo down. Me kangaroo down. You must do the kangaroo down. Zero, dear.
Yes, why not sing it again with us as we present for the next 30 minutes a quick-fire sequence of popular melodies, old and new.
The words and music make you want to sing it and then just take that catchy tune and sing it again.
Sing something simple as cares.
time in Britain is 12 noon. In Germany, it's 1 p.m. But at home and away, once again, it's time for two-way family favorites.
Radio Prune is free radio without inhibitions or censorship, dedicating itself to the promotion of radicalism, liberalism, anti-racialism, and dirty jokes. We will be dedicating many broadcasts to the rights of free speech, bringing together famous politicians, moralists, and clergymen to discuss controversial issues and tell dirty jokes. But from now on, every program will be full frontal. We believe the full beauty of the human body is something everyone should be able to listen to whenever they wish.
With this in mind, amongst our forthcoming presentations will be in the morning, 8 o'clock nudes, and then nudes bulletins every half hour. This will be followed by Lift Up Your Skirts and Drop Gear with John Peel.
Hello, anybody there?
Oh, hello, I'm Julian. This is my friend Sandy.
Oh, hello, Mr. Owen. Oh, welcome to our guest, Lattie. Thank you. Oh, welcome, yes, to the guest, Lattie. It's a proper home from Omi.
Yeah. And how long have you been hotelier?
Not long, but of course we knew Bogmouth well, didn't
what?
We? Oh, we used to do your summer seasons down here, entertaining, you know.
Yes, we was at the Smuggler's Nook year after year.
Yes, songs at the piano. Oh, they'd let their rye right down when we got going. You know the sort of thing. Jewel, get on the piano.
Shall I?
Get on the piano. Yeah. Or allow your lappers on the Striller's boner.
Time is just now 10 minutes to 12. This is David Dunhill, and this is the end of the home service for today and for all days. In one sense, I suppose, we're like a bride on the eve of her wedding. We go on being the same person, we hope, but we'll never again have the same name. Tomorrow at 6:35 a.m. we become Radio 4, and we expect to live happily ever afterwards. So, goodbye, home service. Two of the best words in the British language.
Here's news. Starting in September, the BBC begins a new service for fans of popular music. There'll be light. And then there's pop. And then there's always. Oh, excuse me.
Well, there we end broadcasting in the Light Programme, not just for today, but as it seems, forever. The Light Programme, that is, well, as it's known now, is closing down.
This is BBC Radio 2, the Light Programme, and on 1500 metres long wave and VHF, with Radio 1 on 247 metres. Good morning, this is Paul Hollingdale on this opening day of Radio 1 and Radio 2, welcoming you to Breakfast Special, which will be broadcast on the usual Light Programme wavelengths up to 7 o'clock.
In very little time now, it will be my pleasure and privilege to launch Radio 1 and 2. All of us here who have worked so hard during these past weeks have done so with two principal aims in view: to provide you with a better service of popular music and a greater measure of choice.
Radio 2, Radio 1, go!
The voice of Radio 1! Just for fun!
Music!
Too much.
And good morning, everyone. Welcome to the exciting new sound of Radio 1.
Hello,
Yes, indeed, we've even got Arnold back. Hello, everyone. Welcome to the first of the Tony Blackburn shows. I shall be waking up every morning, except Sunday, between 7 and 8.30. So let's away!
When I say it's 12.01, it means we're going to have some fun. 12.02 means great Scottsaboo, how are you? 12.03, we're on a street. 12.04, we're going to walk right out the door with some fantastic sounds. 12.05, time to come alive. 12.06, that don't rhyme, not all the time. All right. 12.07, we're going to heaven. 12.08, we can't hesitate, can't wait. 12.09, make you feel mighty fine. And 12.10, well, we're going to hear from Big Ben. Right now, let me say one little thing. One little thing before we go on to another fantastic record on BBC One. It's 12.11, we're going to heaven. You're listening to the Emperor Roscoe. That's R-O-S-K-O.
12.30 on Radio 1, the news in English. The Merseyside dock strike goes on. About 5,000 men met in Liverpool this morning. The new sound is Auntie Agogo. The London Evening News story reads, Goodbye Auntie, Hello Pop. The BBC, standing for Beatles, Bee Gees and Cliff, went jingle, jangle, jingle.
It's a radio wonderful weekend.
Here we go! Bowling!
Hello, darling!
I hope you like the records I'm playing on my groovy gramophone. Just stick around and you'll hear the latest on the electric radio. There's lots of fun on Radio 1. Lots of fun on Radio 1. If we miss out one of your favorites, write a postcard, let us know. Our only aim is keeping you happy on the Kenny Everett Show. There's lots of fun on Radio 1. There's lots of fun on Radio 1. Lots of fun on radio.
Each week, a well-known person is asked the question, if you were to be cast away alone on a desert island, which 8 gramophone records would you choose to have with you? As usual, the castaway is introduced by Roy Plumley.
On our desert island this week, ladies and gentlemen, Arthur Askey,
Peter Ustinov,
David Niven,
Her Royal Highness Princess Margaret, Countess of Snow,
Les Dawson,
Jacqueline Dupre,
Sir Ralph Richardson,
Bernard Levy,
Sue Lawley,
Roy Hattersley,
Benny Green,
Aubrey Waugh,
Bill Bryson, Jonathan Miller, Seamus Heaney, Dirk Bogarde, Dame Vera Lynn, Tony Blair, John Peel, Terence Stamp, Alexander McCall Smith,
Betty Driver, Professor Brian Cox, Sir Terry Wogan, Sebastian Coe, Sir David Attenborough.
Certainly were.
What's up?
Midnight couldn't have been tidied. Look, she's going back into the stable.
What? No, Grace. No, don't do it.
She's going in after midnight.
Grace! Grace! Grace, come back. The roof's collapsing. For God's sake, Grace, come back.
Oh, no, me old beauty. Oh, no. I'm going to give you the shock of your life. Here. Now come along with me and keep quiet.
I've got it now! I've just... Oh, friends! Nigel! David! Nigel, hang on!
Ah! Nigel!
Today, the World This Weekend gives special expanded coverage to America at War with Itself.
The World at One. This is Brian Widlake with 40 minutes of news and comment this Monday lunchtime.
It's PM at 5 PM. This is William Hardcastle
and Derek Cooper
with the programme that sums up the day, and your evening starts here.
From the Today studio at just about 15 minutes. I can't read your writing. I've got a chap writing it out for me here, the silly fool. I can't read his writing.
Radio 3 on 464 metres, 647 kilohertz and VHF. The Foreign Secretary, Mr. Anthony Crossland, has died in hospital at Oxford at the age of 58.
In tonight's newsbeat, why young policemen may demand strike action for more pay and what happened on Roger Vadim's wedding night with Brigitte Bardot. Newsbeat!
And it looks as if Britain may have its first woman prime minister today. With 503 results already declared, the Conservatives have gained 44 seats.
The closing exchange rates in Tokyo were 161.85 yen to the dollar, 1.4565 dollars to the pound, and 1.9710 Deutschmarks to the dollar. That makes you feel much better.
Isn't that amazing? I don't even know whether that's good news or bad news. Let's call it good news, Christmas Eve.
At 12:30, Saddam's forces fight back for control of Iraq. The communists cling on in Albania. And it's the Right Honourable Symes. Or is it?
Newsbeat with Mallory Gelb.
The World Tonight. Good evening, this is Alexander MacLeod. The Sinn Féin leader, Gerry Adams, has arrived in New York after being allowed a visa for the first time for 20 years.
This is BBC Radio Leicester.
To serve local people, to promote their interests, to promote their prosperity, to inform them what was going on in their neighbourhood, to be a forum for the discussion of their problems, in every way to help the local community and to make local life more interesting and to enrich the standard, the quality of life locally. That was what I wanted local radio to do, and I felt that there was a very great need in Britain for that kind of service.
Good afternoon from Radio Leicester, broadcasting on 95.05 VHF.
This is BBC Radio Sheffield on 88.6 VHF.
This is BBC Radio Stoke-on-Trent.
Radio Nottingham on VHF 94.8 and Rediffusion Channel C. Remember our slogan, tune in and listen, come in and take part.
Radio Merseyside.
This is BBC Radio Bristol.
BBC Radio, the away we go.
This is Radio Manchester. Radio Manchester.
Well, here we are. We've arrived. Time now is exactly 6:25. You're in tune with BBC Radio Manchester.
My name is Selina Thirkel. I live number 2 Jedburgh Street, Middlesbrough, Teesside, and I'm an usherette at the ABC Stockton. On behalf of the people of Teesside, I would like to give a welcome to our own local radio station, BBC Radio Teesside.
And hello, I'm the Ross Bit of the Ross and Henry Show.
And on this groovy Saturday morning, you're listening to John Henry and to Leslie Ross. Stay tuned, because there's more good sound to come.
Radio Humberside, BBC.
Radio Lincolnshire News, it's 5:10.
The music sounds best any way you play it.
On 94.9 FM and 1458 AM, and on London Plus, this for the first time is Greater London Radio.
Greater London Radio, GWR.
Start your day with CWR. CWR.
Wabba, the news and views of the county. From Radio Kent.
My producer, Tony Smith, discovered that this is my 500th Down Your Way programme, and to mark the occasion, we've accepted a kind invitation to visit the old village of Hambledon in Hampshire.
BBC World Service presents Radio Newsreel. Outlook. Introduced by John Tidmarsh.
BBC World Service Sports Roundup.
We have no less than six different places to go to between now and 17:45 Greenwich Mean Time. We've got to go to Lord's for the Benson Hedges Cup final there between Somerset and Nottinghamshire.
Hello, this is Margaret Howard back again with Letterbox.
A jolly good show. And this is David Lee Travis with you again with all the requests.
BBC Afrique, la radio de référence.
Kulantu wanaksende gistial, halka nagada gisini sana wa BBC London.
It's Kasim Kayira on BBC Network Africa.
This is the BBC in Beijing.
Kampala.
Reykjavik.
Delhi.
Wherever you are, you're with the BBC.
BBC World Service. This is James Menendez with NewsHour.
I'm afraid one thing's never going to change. I shall always worry about you, Jim.
Pete Murray.
Did the cocaine overture, the critical reaction on the whole was extremely good, but one or two critics did say that you had perhaps rather a stiff wrist.
I don't think it was really very stiff, but on the whole I prefer conducting without a stick and just with hands, because I think hands are so much more expressive.
Again, and welcome once more to our mini-marathon of favourite music for this Sunday morning.
Friday night is music night.
It's David Hamilton's Hot Shot.
Jensen, Paul Gambaccini, Tom Brown, Anne Nightingale, Noel Redmond, David Hamilton.
Raymond Bates, Jimmy Savile, Alan Freeman, Dave Lee, Travis, Adrian Just, Andy Peebles, Mike Reed, Steve Wright, Richard Skinner, Tommy Vance, Keith Chegwin, Gary Davis, Mike Smith, Peter Powell, Simon Mayo, Lenny Henry,
Gary King, Mark Goodyear, 1FM.
Radio 1.
And on a Monday to Thursday, 8 to 10.
David Jensen, David Jensen.
On Tuesday, Friday, 2, 8, 5.
David Jensen, David Jensen.
After a week in the daylight doing the Simon Bates program, I'm back in the night. From 8 till 10 o'clock, and on tonight's program, it's three of the best from John Lennon and a new session from Wah.
Well, guess who's back on top of the First Division tonight? It sounds like a blinder of a match. Forest leading 3-2 at half-time at Anfield. Liverpool won 4-3 in the end. Hodgson 2, Souness and Rush. And anyway, into the programme, we've got the Sisters of Mercy and the Beat amongst the records, Comsat Angels, the Gun Club, a little surf music, because I like you, Red Lorry, Yellow Lorry, Lee Perry, Hunters and Collectors, Personal Column, Deutsche Amerikanische Freundschaft, Ludus, The Birthday Party, French Impressionists, The Mad Professor, Meat Puppets, Sunny A Day, and to start the programme, Dead or Alive.
The Golden Hour on Radio 1.
And a couple of birthdays just to kick off. Part 2, Sandra Statter. Or maybe it's Sandra Starter, as in Cold Mornings, who lives in Cleveland Drive in Lancashire, has a birthday today, and she is 25. And also Keith David Mott, and they both share their birthday with a gentleman by the name of Freddie Mercury. Happy birthday.
Let's go.
Tomorrow morning, the Radio 1 Roadshow comes to you live from the Promenade Minehead with Tony Blackburn. Don't forget, the fun starts at 10.
The right
song. Well, I'm rapidly running out of time. We have a choice of one more. What should we go for? Here's the choice. You can go for Cool and the Gang and Cherish, Yazoo, Nobody's Diary, Michael Jackson's Thriller. Oh, we haven't got enough time for that. A bit of Meatloaf or Spandau Ballet, Duran Duran. Approved? Deal? All right. Duran Duran it will be. This is Save a Prayer. Probably the nicest ballad they ever did. And on compact disc, well. And if the record industries are listening, we've just proved that someday all DJs will operate in this way.
You saw me.
Hello, this is Bill Brecken and Nancy Wise with today's You and Yours.
This week we're going to look at various ways of making a diminishing pound go further in the kitchen. We'll be examining the new cheaply packaged generic products that are appearing in the supermarkets and asking, are they worth buying? And meeting a militant pensioner whose purchasing is done with single-minded efficiency.
This week, why were they dark and golden-eyed? Or will the real Clark Kent sit down? Or is science fiction becoming respectable? Brian Aldriss draws a map of the universe on Bookshelf.
You'll do the breakaway by and by.
Hello, and welcome to the final edition of Breakaway, in which we'll be looking at how travel has changed in the former Eastern Europe.
So if you ask me, is it possible to produce top-quality fruit and vegetables and flowers without spread, without using the what I call the really poisonous, persistent chemicals, which I deplore entirely, the answer would be yes, because I've done it.
Misguided generosity has apparently now led you to suppose that I could find some use for 10 lords a-leaping. They might lend a hand with cleaning up all the rancid milk and birdlime if they could only stop leaping around after the dancing girls for 5 minutes.
We're very sorry about that. But now...
A Scriptwriter's Guide to the Galaxy by a man who would rather write Doctor Who. Starring Peter Jones as this bit.
Far out in the uncharted backwaters of the unfashionable end of the western spiral arm of the galaxy lies a small, unregarded yellow sun. Orbiting this at a distance of roughly 90 million miles is an utterly insignificant little blue-green planet whose ape-descended life forms are so amazingly primitive that they still think digital watches are a pretty neat idea.
And a great good morning. Hi, Mike Flix here. Look after yourselves and thanks for the money. My name is Mike Flix.
Mike Flix.
Yep, Mike Flix. And by one of those happy coincidences, this is the Mike Flix Show. And thank you for all those of you who wrote in for the Find a New Name for Mike Flix competition. We still haven't picked the winner, but thank you to Joy for suggesting Old Dustbin Head. We'll have a brand new competition later on, and we'll be inviting you to find a name for the microphone. So, plenty of fun there, I would think. Well, you're listening to...
Radioactive!
Next! Well, Mr. Friggins.
Oh, hello, Doctor.
Now, what seems to be the problem this time?
I wondered if you could give me something for this.
Six o'clock on Radio 1 and 2. This is the Top 20 as compiled for the BBC by the British Market Research Bureau.
We have a new entry at...
Number 26.
From Darren Darren.
Number 10, it's Utah Saints, What Can You Do For Me? 9, going down 3 places, The Prodigy and Charlie. 8, up 1, Sabrina Johnson, Peace. And at 7, climbing 6, Rosala, Everybody's Free to Feel Good. 6, down 1, Zoe, Sunshine on a Rainy Day. At 5, falling 3 places, Right Said Fred, I'm Too Sexy. Number 4, climbing 3, Erasure, Love to Hate You. And at 3, it climbs 1, Oceanic Insanity. Last week's 3 is up to number 2, Salt and Pepper, Let's Talk About Sex. And so it's congratulations to Brian Adams for a staggering 12th week, he is...
UK's number one!
If I am asked today what I think about family life after 25 years of marriage, I can answer with equal simplicity and conviction. I am for it.
Born to be King. A cycle of plays on the life of Jesus Christ.
Barnsley Council's nuclear bomb-proof shelter has been closed after being destroyed by vandals.
A scaffolder was unaware that he'd shot himself in the head with a rivet gun until he went to the canteen and found he couldn't take his hard hat off.
Owing to drought and shortage of water, we have closed 3 lanes of the swimming pool.
Window and saw, to my surprise, that they were being openly merchandised.
Clement Freud challenged.
Repetition of openly.
Yes, you did say openly. Openly sold over the counter.
Well, he shouldn't come in on it. He couldn't even start on it.
Folkestone Road.
Mornington Crescent.
Yeah.
The undisputed expert's expert was Lionel Blair, who was particularly good at Mickey Mouse cartoons. However, he occasionally had to save the day when he was let down by his team. Una Stubbs still recalls how amazed she was when Christopher Biggins failed miserably with Fantasia, and Lionel was straight in behind him with his Steamboat Willie.
Wince, a setting on Jonathan Ross's washing machine.
Monogamy. Celebrating New Year in Scotland by yourself.
Radar, an attack by pirates.
Algorithm,
former vice president on drums.
Dudar, a cool pirate. Bazaar. Barry the pirate.
Radio 2 is on the moon. In a little while you see 693 or 909. Kilohertz is where we'll be. If your dial is marked in meters, here's what you need to know. Look for us at 433 or 330. Radio 2 on medium wave and stereo VHF for you.
No one left to put the record on.
275 and 285. The lovely Princess Radio 3 has been asleep, awaiting the prince, who will come through the thickets of frequencies and wavelengths, electronic foliage tendrilling in and out of jack fields all over the country. And now the lilac fairy has done her stuff again and guided you through all the obstacles put in your way by the wicked Albanian Carabos, and brought you to the land at the other end of the cyclorama. Wonderful 247 meters. And the weatherman has found us, and with a kiss roused us to start a new lease of life.
Traffic jams at Highbury, official and unofficial cops drilling a hole through masses of humanity to get a sports reporter there on time. Smoky studios, the smoked salmon voice of John Webster, the Finn and Haddie crackle of Angus Mackay's over the headphones, the ticking of that clock there that only those of us in the studio can hear.
I proclaim open the Olympic Games of London, celebrating at the 14th Olympiad of the modern era.
To Oxford in the lead, I think. It's almost neck and neck. It's level, I should think. I'm not quite sure. It must be level. Cambridge picking up the stroke. I think Cambridge are ahead. I don't know who's ahead. It's either Oxford or Cambridge. It's neck and neck the whole way over. This much.
Bowles turns it on to Manic Appeals. He's out LBW and Lakers taking all 10. The first man to congratulate him is Ian Johnson.
Headed away by Jack Charlton down to Nobby Stiles. Stiles with a long ball through to Ball, and Ball will run for all he's worth after this one. He turns it in. Can Hurst get a shot in? There's a chance for Jeff Hurst, and he's hit the bar. It must be a goal. I would have thought that went in, but he's not given it.
0-0 at the moment for Luton, and Luton have got a free kick coming up now, which Bobby Thompson is just going to take. Yes, Anderson, it's there! It's there! How about that? How about that?
Red Rom has 200 yards to run to make history. Tommy Stack is pushing Red Rom. The excitement here is tremendous. Red Rom has done it for a third time. Red Rom,
you're listening to Sports Report on National Radio 2. My name's John Inverdale, and this is a tragic day for sport.
The teams have just left the field here, taken away by referee Ray Lewis. Away to the left at the moment, there must be some 100 or 200 people on the pitch. They're 20 yards onto the pitch. I see people lying down. I see people there shaking their heads. St. John's ambulance people are there. Right footed, it's a clear header, and it's lifted into the net. Solskjaer has won the European Cup for Manchester United.
4-4 is 5-5.
Good afternoon, Jim Rosenthal here. Welcome to the last Sport on 2 of 1979.
There were several personal battles. Octopus Whiteside, whose elbows are from the Hammer Book of Horrors, versus McCarthy and Clements. Both the latter were booked. Norman wins on points. But Division 2 and a distraught bank manager await City.
BBC Radio 2 Traffic News.
Yeah, the situation in the air this morning, there's good weather here and on the continent, and there are no problems for air travellers on the domestic or European routes this morning. The windsock hanging limply in the autumnal air down at Gatport Airwick this morning. On the Rattlers, things are good too on mainline and intercity services, but there are one or two cancellations on local services on British Rail's southern region into Holborn, Victoria and Charing Cross. There are two cancellations on eastern region from Shenfield into Liverpool Street. And the Sharers are still having a spot of bother too. National Express coaches still having problems with an industrial dispute at Northampton, and so the picking up point is still at Campbell Square and not at Greyfriars bus station, all right?
Terry Wogan.
I did say we had a couple of seconds last week. In fact, I think we had three of them, but nearly a winner. And that I was getting a little bit cheesed off with that. So we were determined to have a winner yesterday, and stat me vital, Sir Henry, if we didn't.
Ah, Chuffer Dandridge, my old nearly departed numpties. I was enthralled to hear Boggy mention the other day he wore a pillbox hat in the boys' brigade.
Oh, yes, I did, yes.
He must have been popular. Is he sure he wasn't a lift attendant somewhere? You'll be thrilled to hear that droves and throngs of people have been pestering me for it. More info on the time Boggy and I did a cabaret act together.
Oh, yes.
He'll remember it. Heady days, eh? Our Halloween number was a showstopper. It was called...
Oh, no.
Ghosties and Ghoulies. In the first act, Boggy... with China torch on my ghosties. The second, I'd shine a set of dessert spoons till they gleamed. Now, I'm not going to pretend that this is not a sad day. You'll probably hear it in my voice. I'm going to miss the laughter and the fun of our mornings together. I know you're going to welcome Chris Evans with the same generosity of spirit that you've always shown me. So, I'm going to miss you. Till we're together again in February. Have a happy Christmas. Thank you. Thank you for being my friend.
Morning all, thanks to Bill Murray for Open House, and a warm welcome to the JY Show. In today's programme, we'll be finding out why innocent people are being convicted in the courts as a result of plea bargaining. I'm hoping that we'll be able to talk to the field officer of Age Concern on why she believes that women should work harder and die younger.
Let's hear about home. Gotta keep
today, Jim.
What of the accusation, and I read it only the other day, that it's your philosophy of, the quote which was used was, your philosophy of ruthless individualism, which has in fact created the ruthless individual.
Oh, nonsense. The individual has freedom of choice. Surely that's what the sanctity of the human being means. That's what human rights mean. There's a fundamental right to liberty.
And it's JY saying BFN, bye for now.
Brum, brum, brum. Hello again, good afternoon to you. Well now, does it feel any different to be on these medium waves rather than on the comfortable old long ones?
I wonder if you know which composer once wrote this to a friend. All my life, I have considered vocal composition inferior to instrumental music. I have never regarded it as a great art, but don't tell anyone about it. Well, believe it or not, that was Schumann. And what's more surprising is that he made the statement in 1839.
BBC Radio 3 at 10:15.
Well, after Hamburg and Saxony, a more usual port of call on the first morning of the year is, of course, Vienna. So now it's time for the traditional New Year's Day concert from Vienna, where we join Richard Baker.
Good evening from the Royal Festival Hall in London, where the Royal Philharmonic Society is presenting the last concert of their present season. It's being given by the English Chamber Orchestra, Lieder Kenneth Sillitoe, directed by Pinchas Zukerman, with Philip Ledger, harpsichord continuo.
This is the Open University.
Good evening. I'm pleased to greet you again with another selection of your favorite music. Some of the tunes you've specially asked to hear. I hope you enjoy them.
Hello. Today in the programme we have cookery, but from the printed page. In fact, we're going to look at the huge market for cookery books. And we visit Stoke Mandeville Hospital for spinal injuries. We learn about wallpapering well. And we have a short story by Charles Causley called A Sailor at Waterloo. And it's going to be read for us by Sean Arnold.
You'll be a bit of a celeb in your own right, which you deserve to be. I've always thought you've hid your life under a bushel.
But you know,
huddled in this little studio. Well, what a dank little place. What's that funny smell?
Well, it could be our rather ancient cooker in the corner. You notice we have a cooker there.
I do. Do you live here?
Well, it sometimes feels like it.
There's damp in here somewhere.
Many an aubergine has exploded that afternoon.
An aubergine exploding. What an image, listeners.
Good morning from me, Piers Burton Page, and welcome to On Air. Over the next 2 hours, we have music by Vivaldi, Mendelssohn, Johann Strauss the Younger, and Johann Sebastian Bach, amongst others.
And now here is next week's news. The weekend. The Director General of the BBC denies Equity's claim that the corporation is a penny-a-week boss, and says he's getting at least three times as much as that.
Je suis la radio à Londres.
Oui.
Yes, Hong Kong, yes.
Yes, good morning, Hong Kong.
Hello, Michigan.
Hello, London, this is New York. Are you trying to reach us?
Allô? De 05 à 15, 10 minutes.
NBC News, New York. Loud and clear, kid, do you read me?
For what is my first venture in this illustrious chair, I'm delighted to welcome Antonia Fraser, who, as you probably know, writes massive works of history and biography that manage to be both erudite and popular. Roy Hattersley is the Shadow Home Secretary and Deputy Leader of the Labour Party. Mr. Hattersley is also given to confessions. In one of the many articles that he writes, he said, "I believe people really care about me only if they give me chocolate." Norman Tebbit is chairman of the Conservative Party. Until the election, he was one of the most senior and influential members of Mrs. Thatcher's cabinet. His decision to step down has led some people to conclude that he no longer wants to be prime minister. Others, however, are convinced that precisely the opposite is indicated.
It's 12 noon in London, 7 a.m. in Philadelphia. Around the world, it's time for Live Aid.
Mr. Eric Sykes, Sir John Mortimer, Sir Peter O'Sullivan, Sir Jimmy Young, Marvin Hamlisch, Clive James, Tony Bennett, Timothy West, Stephen Frears, Diana Quick, Dame Eileen Atkins, Dame Judy Dench, Dame Helen Mirren, Dame Joan Collins, Dame Maggie Smith, Jason Donovan, Joan Collins, Joe Brand, Ian McKellen, Diana Rigg, Mr. Ronnie Corbett, Roger Moore, Sheila Hancock, Sir Peter Hall, Tom Courtney, David Threlfall, Robert Downey Jr., Sir Anthony Sher.
Stop the Week with Robert Robinson.
Mr. Gordon, what groups of people were known by the collective noun a dignity? A dignity of, and who were they? I don't believe it for 1 minute, but it's rather charming.
Alderman.
No. Good try, Dr. Perry.
Bishops.
Not bishops. Mr. Paxton.
Judges.
Not judges. Mr. Milnes.
Lords.
No, canons of the church. Well, I think it was an explosion of canons. Rotten joke. Forget I said it.
Now, the 2000th edition of Alistair Cook's Letter from America.
Good morning. My mother-in-law came from the deep south, her family having come long ago from France and gone into New Orleans and then on to Galveston, Texas. She used to shake her head over the many peculiar habits of her three daughters, all born in the North. She was mildly offended by their slang, way back there in the 1930s, of words like okay and lousy. She simply tolerated their accents, which she thought harsh. They say mother, she would complain. Of course, they didn't say mother, but they didn't say mother either.
Coming soon to this spot on the dial, Radio 5, the new home of Radio Sport. For Radio 2, tune to FM 88 to 91.
Testing, testing, 1, 2, 3. Can you hear me in there?
Oh, hang on a minute, Trev, hang on.
Look, do you know, you don't know how to operate a radio studio, do you? You don't?
No, I do. It's easy, honestly. I mean, an idiot could work this.
Yeah, that's quite appropriate then, isn't it? Get on with it then.
Okay.
Radio 1! Yeah!
Hello, good morning. Welcome to Radio 5.
Welcome to the brand new network and the first special holiday program on Radio 5. Take 5. I'm Bruno Brooks. We've got some great music for you.
Morning edition from BBC Radio 5.
Good morning. Breakfast with the Morning Edition team and start your day in a relaxed and congenial way.
Good morning. Welcome to a new network, Radio 5 Live. News and sport from the BBC, 24 hours a day. It's 5 o'clock on Monday, the 28th of March. I'm Jane Garvey and this is Morning Reports. The news headlines. 30 are dead in tornadoes in America, most of them crushed when a church collapsed. John Major faces a tough new choice over Europe, and there's a big increase in allegations of racism by the police.
In sport, Manchester United's dream of the domestic treble is over. Aston Villa beat them by 3-1 in a memorable Coca-Cola Cup final at Wembley. There's a full sports bulletin at 5:30.
I'm Adrian Childs. It's a big week for Westland Helicopters. Will shareholders fall for the charms of GKN? Well, wake up to money with me at 5:45.
Hey, boys and girls, have you seen my career?
Yes, it's behind you.
Forget it. I'll be a traffic warden. Ta-da.
For BBC Radio 1 FM, Adrian Just was a Shodagon production.
1 FM, Simon Mayer.
Coming up between 8 and 9.
Oh, fine, don't include me in the joke, man. 8 o'clock, it's Tuesday, July the 2nd, 1991. Hello. Michael Hutchins is on the line already. We'll talk to him about our competition just a few minutes' time. We'll do a confession. We'll do Only Stay in History. Philip Schofield speaking live about the roadshow from Northern Ireland today. And Dream Warriors, Erasure, ELO, Whitney Houston, The Tourists, The Record of the Week from Bomb the Bass, and The Blow Monkeys.
It's now 7 o'clock on Monday, the 24th of April, 1995, a day that will go down in history. History as the day we are back on that radio map. Marconi's listening in the heavens, and Marconi, I thank you. Can do the technical bits as well, you see. That's a great bonus for me. Not only am I very funny, but I can actually do the job.
Good morning and welcome to the world famous Radio 1 Breakfast Show. And hey, enjoy it while it lasts, people.
Please release me.
Well, look, the big story in the papers today is the fact that we're leaving the show. We're leaving the show. We aren't actually leaving the show. We didn't want to leave the show.
And this is the truth behind the story. I've got to tell you the truth behind the story. This is absolutely how it is, OK? In the middle of last summer, I asked for Fridays off because we've got to do the TV show. Now, I waited till the middle of last summer because I didn't know if the TV show was going to be a success or not. If it wasn't, I'd carry on doing the radio, but I thought that's fair enough.
The Radio 1 Breakfast Show.
I'm doing really well, actually.
No, not you. How are you doing?
Oh, sorry. Yes, how are you all doing?
It's really weird having someone answering back all the time.
I tell you something.
Yeah?
I love radio.
Raymond Sinclair.
We're the Spice Girls. Welcome to a very spicy Christmas.
Ho, ho, ho.
When you're feeling sad and low.
This is Radio 1. Now here's Richard Evans with a special news bulletin.
Diana, Princess of Wales and Dodi Fayed have been killed in a car crash in Paris. The accident happened as their car was being chased by photographers through a road tunnel near the Eiffel Tower. The princess died in hospital a few hours later.
When I first started feeling funny, that is when I still had hair. It was hardly noticeable at first. There was hardly nothing wrong, except I was tired a bit. But then Mum was very worried that I was thinner and thinner, and one day I might fade away to a speck, and that I was looking peaky. But because I'm backwards, then I wasn't very good at saying what is wrong, so she took me straight to the doctor in case I'd disappeared.
Good Eve News! Today's leading items, classified and abbreviated into a taster section, which serves as a prelude to more detailed elucidation.
The headlines.
Brilliant professor unplugged by careless cleaner, 300-ton flag pulled out of shepherd, and 7-inch man in catering sabotage.
On the hour.
This is BBC Radio 4.
This is Eugene Fraser welcoming you to BBC Radio 4 on 200 kHz, 1500 metres long wave and VHF FM in England.
Now the shipping forecast issued by the Met Office at 2330 on the 13th of September.
Cromarty, west or northwest, 4 or 5. Rain or showers, moderate or good.
Humber, south 5, becoming variable 4. Thundery showers later, moderate or good.
Mallon, Hebrides, southwest 5 to 7, perhaps gale 8. Later in Hebrides, rain or showers, moderate or good.
Faroe, Faroes, southeast Iceland. Easterly or northeasterly 5 to 7, occasionally gale 8 in western southeast Iceland. Rain or showers, good, occasionally poor.
Tyree Automatic, northwest 1, 10 miles, 1025, rising slowly.
Rattray Head to Berwick upon Tweed, wind north force 5 or 6, decreasing 4, occasional rain. Visibility moderate with fog patches.
BBC News at 6 o'clock. This is Peter Donaldson.
Abbey Man also won several Emmys, including one in 1973 for a film which featured a police detective called Kim Kojak.
BBC Radio 4, of which I am the daddy. Business news now, and there's been a merging of two pharmaceutical giants. But Glaxo, welcome. And SmithKline Beecham. Here's Charlotte Green with the details.
The new company is to be known simply as GlaxoSmithKline. Other potential name merges include Vodafone and Manusman, presumably to form Vodaman, with apologies to Carol, and Walmart and Asda, Wazda.
This is Six Music
from the BBC.
Good morning, it's Monday, the 11th of March 2002, and you're listening to Six Music from the BBC. My name is Phil Jupitus. I'll be your host for the next year. How are you doing? As you probably know, we've been having something of a vote on the internet for the first record to be played on Six Music, and you're probably wondering, Phil, who's won?
Best of hot new music. This is
BBC Radio 1 Extra.
Friction Show, the best in deadly talent. Your friend.
Hello again. Unless this is the first time we've met today, in which case, just hello. I'm Jim Lee, and on the way is the Classic Comedy Hour, where the secrets of BBC Radio are about to be exposed in Stop Messing About. Then it's the random jottings of Hinge and Bracket, and this week they're giving the homestead a bit of a revamp and getting stuck into flat-pack furniture. And an hour from now, at 8 o'clock, the rather urbane detective Paul Temple gets involved with the murder of an impresario's daughter in Paul Temple and the Spencer Affair.
BBC Radio 4 Extra.
Well, Sid the manager online, hello?
Hello, boy! Hello, Steve, hello, Pussy!
Hello there! Oh, well, Elvis! My goodness, how nice to see you.
We're an afternoon scene.
Factoids.
Just love the show. Bye.
The greatest always was, always will be. That's one of the thousands of tributes to Radio 1's John Peel, who died last night. He was 65 and had a heart attack on holiday in Peru. His wife Sheila was with him.
An astonishing series of acts of terrorism has been perpetrated in the United States. Countless numbers of people were killed and injured when at least three apparently hijacked passenger aircraft were flown into
buildings. But then seconds later, there were two or three more very big explosions, and this building, this huge building, towering into the sky, again, physically shook, and at that point, people came screaming past me saying, just get out, just get out, just get out.
Andrew, this is Russell Brand. I'm so sorry about the last message. It was part of the radio show. It was a mistake.
Just a joke. If there is any truth in that, I don't know. It was just a joke.
And it was Russell, just a joke,
Russell
basically.
Asked me to say it as a joke.
It was just a joke that we'd done, basically. I didn't ask him to say it, though. But, you know, aside from that bit, this one's true and the last one's not true. And this, look.
Well, it might be true, but we didn't want to break it to you in such a harsh way.
Right, okay, look, the truth is, look, Andrew, I'm phoning you to ask if I can marry, that's right, marry your granddaughter.
Saturday morning on Five Live.
Morning, everyone. If you're holding on, be right to you, because we've got some tremendous pig's tail update after we've discovered a 1947 can of pig's tails, which is surely the winner of our expiry date poker.
Radio 1 Podcast.
Radio 1.
Day is dawning.
bed and shake your ass, 'cause Mr. Moyles is here.
So it's a brand new show, completely different to anything you've ever heard before. Moyles' Big Ones coming up. No, I'm joking. And it's the same people that used to be on in the afternoon. Dave's here, Comedy Day.
Hello and good morning.
When I say pub, you say quiz. Pub
quiz.
Pub quiz.
Pub quiz.
Pub quiz. What's up?
What's bread? Brown bread. Diplomatic immunity. Give me wings, Officer Murta.
37 hours. Simon Mayo did for Comet Relief back in 1999. As soon as we go over 37 hours, we've broken the record.
Yeah.
It's us. Our name goes down in the radio and history books. Booyah. No matter how embarrassed they get of me, Ollie, they can never erase it.
Yeah. No.
It's done.
I'm at the post office.
And then you go in.
I'm on the moon.
I'm on the moon, lovely.
Well done. I'm at the Great Wall of China.
And then you're going to get your hair done.
I'm in the hair salon.
Goodbye, Great Britain.
He's waving.
We're listening to BBC Radio 3 now, Andrew McGregor, with a special anniversary edition of CD Review.
That first edition of Building a Library, 50 years ago, Beethoven's Fifth Symphony, and just a handful of recordings to consider. Today, over 100 to choose from, including the first one made back in 1913. And Stephen Johnson has listened to as many as he can for today's anniversary edition of Building a Library, coming up at about 9:30.
The time's coming up to 7:40. You're listening to Today with James Naughty.
Yeah. Obviously, that is quite specific in that it can only be played at about 20 to 8.
He can bring a politician to his knees. He don't take no shit, John Humphreys.
And my personal favourite,
he's a wry old wag,
Melvin Bragg.
As I said on Wednesday's programme, many listeners reported having success with politely saying to people who littered something along the lines of, I think you've dropped something. Matt Peake, for example, does an Alice Arnold all the time.
The coalition's made 30 post-consultative policy announcements, or U-turns. But can you name them all? Standing by is James Robbins from The World This Weekend, who must remember as many as he can from this list, read by Neil Sleet.
A cap on tax relief on donations. A tax on takeaway food served above ambient temperature. A tax on static caravans.
You wanted to see me, Minister.
Yes, why wasn't I told about these fingerprint checks?
You didn't ask, Minister.
Well, I shouldn't need to ask.
On the contrary, Minister, I can't tell you if you don't ask, because once I've told you, you know. And it might be better if you didn't know.
Well, why would I want not to know?
Because once you know, then you can't say you didn't know.
So if I don't know, I shouldn't ask, because once I know, I can't say I didn't know. That's ridiculous.
I know, but you never know when you might need to claim you didn't know, in which case it's much better that you actually didn't know, rather than having to pretend you didn't know when in fact you knew. So if I know, it would be better for you not to know, I make sure you don't ask.
And if I do ask?
I claim I don't know. The Now Show!
This is your reminder to call the vet.
In which year did this week's top three have Annie's Song by James Galway at number three, The Smurfs Song by Father Abraham at number two, and You're the One That I Want by John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John at number one?
77.
Is 1 year?
Usually 1 year.
Oh, 78 it was. 88 to 91 FM.
Join BBC Radio 2 for the conclusion of Sounds of the 20th Century.
Dawn, and as the sun breaks through the piercing chill of night on the plain outside Coram, it lights up a biblical famine.
Last week, 1,000 jobs were lost every day.
With 250 yards to go, 25-year-old Bannister took the lead with an amazing burst of speed.
Jeremy Vine introduces the final chapter in our journey through five decades of popular culture.
Four candles. Candles for Forbes.
Tony Blair is to be Prime Minister and a landslide is likely.
The sounds of the 20th century. Thursday night from 10, BBC Radio 2.
But we can't get Bush House itself to say goodbye, but we can say good night. On behalf of the Night Team, this programme was brought to you by
Maggie Jonas, Daniel Griffiths, Bogdan Fry Morgan and Sebastian Paris in the studio, along with editor Katie Dahlstrom, and producers Ron Bowler, Krista Sartori and Jeff credits. Baird.
What? They've all gone into the studio booth, actually. Are they anything
They're all
awake?
Waving at us through
no,
the glass.
No, oh, there, yes, they've woken up now.
Say
bye-bye.
Goodbye. Bye-bye. And it's goodbye from me and Tom as well.
Goodbye.
Until tomorrow, we'll be broadcasting from the new broadcasting house.
Goodbye, Bush.
From them and from me, Julian Marshall.
This is the Olympic Station.
BBC Radio 5 Live.
There are two figures parachuting down from the heavens towards the Olympic Stadium.
And one of them is supposed to be the Queen and the other James Bond.
Oh, that's wonderful. That is absolutely brilliant.
Oh, come on, Team GB. Two medals on the board thanks to girl power. What about our team here with me at the Olympic Park as we broadcast live from London 2012.
Is this the right to glory? Olympian of all time.
And so a stadium roars and a nation roars as Ennis goes on to win the 800 metres and with it, Olympic gold! Can you believe it? It's double gold for Mo Farah, the man who 4 years ago couldn't even reach the Olympic final.
This is the BBC calling the world from London.
Thank God for the good old British BBC. How could a chappy ever anti-auntie search me?
Yeah, quite
right. BBC. BBC.
This is the BBC. Any offers?
Don't challenge.
Sold.